Hello, everyone. Very good evening, family and friends, and thank you so much for joining us on a Friday night. I know we have some new news updates on the safety measures again, but it's very good nonetheless to see. I can't see you guys, but you can see us. But thank you for joining us. My name is Imelda.
We see them in the comments.
Oh, we can see. Okay. Hello, everyone. Okay, later on, okay? I'm very blessed to be able to host this the series called Loaves and Fishes with my good friend, Michelle Yap.
Hello.
And of course, our series is made possible because of our very generous friend and sponsor, Chris Trow from Eden Resources. Now, this series, Loaves and Fishes, is about partaking with family and friends. Our first episode featured my family. So tonight, we have someone very special to Michelle. And you can see this very handsome gentleman in a green shirt. His name is John Yap. And if you can already guess, or you have read from my post details, John is Michelle's father. And he's also a musician, and he will play the guitar with us tonight. And I'm very excited to finally be able to perform with a father and daughter team. Okay. Did you say hello already, Uncle John? Now, the first time I met Uncle John, it was a bit strange because I didn't know whether to call him uncle or not. So I asked him, is it okay if I call you uncle because you're my friend's? You're my friend's father, so it's only polite that I do so. So the first time we met, we were introduced by Boon Chai at Capella, where you were performing regularly at that time. Yes. So I said, is it okay if I call you uncle? Okay. Okay. Now, so tonight, what do we have for everyone?
We're doing a whole set of jazz standards. And, well, I kind of chose all the songs. Because I always hear the songs at home when my dad is practicing the guitar. But usually not complete one, the song.
So we all play complete songs for you tonight.
Play one song, then we'll switch to another song.
Sounds like my son.
And switch to another room to play.
You're exploring the house, lah. Feeling the mood in each room, is it?
Yeah, different vibe.
And which is your favorite room? Kitchen? Do you play in the kitchen?
No.
Toilet gone.
You play in the toilet. I think his favourite is the bed.
Comfortable, lah. Yeah, oh, of course. Okay, so we have a whole hour of jazz standards lined up. And our very first song is something called The Way You Look Tonight. It was first performed by Fred Astaire. Okay, so I did some research, lah, okay? Because I had to have stuff to talk about. So Fred Astaire was a singer before...
I didn't know that. Even
before Frank Sinatra.
Wow.
Yes, I think he's like 20 years older.
I thought 20 years old.
No, 20 years older than Frank Sinatra. Mm. Wow. So anyway, here is something called The Way You Look Tonight, first performed by Fred Astaire in 1936. Someday, when I'm awfully low, when the world is cold, and I will feel a glow just thinking of you and the way you look tonight. You're lovely with your smile so warm and your cheeks so soft. There is nothing for me but to love you. Each word, your tenderness grows, tearing my fears apart. And that laughter that wrinkles your nose, it touches my foolish heart. change. Keep that breathless charm. Won't you please arrange it? Cause I love you and the way you look tonight. Tenderness grows, tearing my fears apart. And that laughter that wrinkles your nose, it touches my foolish heart. You're lovely. Won't you please arrange it? Cause I love you and the way you look tonight. Just the way you look tonight. Thank you very much. And that was The Way You Look Tonight. I can't see you guys, but you can see us. And I'm sure you're all looking smashing tonight in your home wear, which you should be wearing more often now that we have been reduced from 5 to 2 again. So the numbers 5 and 2, right, correspond with our series, right?
Yes, yes.
So from 5 packs to 2 packs to 5 packs to 2 packs, right? So our series is called 5 Loaves and 2 Fishes, which talks about partaking with family and friends and with even with a multitude of people that we don't know. So we're doing this through our music, and we hope you enjoy your time with us on Friday evenings.
Yes, maybe this is a good time to say hello to some friends and family. We have Tom Lau. Sorry, Tom Lau, right?
Lau.
Tom Lau.
That's my father-in-law. Hi,
yeah,
Dad.
My mother's father-in-law. He'll be joining us the next episode.
On the 8th of
yes.
October.
Yes,
yay.
That's right. Looking forward.
Yeah, that'll be quite fun because we also have another special guest called
Tony Z,
who is a very, very recognized drummer from the old days and still very, very current as well. So let's say hello to some friends.
Yeah, on Facebook, right?
Yeah,
I'm on YouTube.
Yeah, okay, I'm on Facebook. Hello, Owen. Hello, Pauline. Hello, Caroline. Hello, Lynn. Hi, Pat. I'm glad you like the song. Joanne. And then who else do we have? Heikel is here.
Oh, Heikel.
Did you prepare any special song for him?
No.
Heikel likes Volare. You want to instrumental Volare later? Okay. Hello, Grace and Trixie and Trisha. Thank you for joining us again. No, Jordan won't be singing tonight, but maybe next time I'll let you know again. Anyway, thank you so much for joining us. And Uncle John, your friend Sunny Yap. Sunny Yap, is that your friend? He says, hello, Brother John. Yeah? Hello. Oh, it's your cousin? Hello, cousin Sunny. So that's your uncle. Do you know him?
I don't know which one, because I don't know him by his English name.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Uncle Sunny, how does Michelle call you?
You can put down in the comments.
Yeah, you can put down in the comments. Hello, Christine. Thank you for joining us. Hello, Kitty. Okay, I'm getting used to this, saying hello to everybody online.
Hello, Kitty.
No, my friend's called Kitty.
Oh.
Yeah, so yes, her name is Kitty.
She's got so happy already.
No. My friend's Kitty, my good friend. Okay, hello, Sophia. Okay, we'll say hello to the rest of you later, okay? Now, for those of you who don't know, John is Michelle's father. Do you see the similarities? Yes? Okay, and they're both very musically inclined. Okay, so the next song that we have for you is... Oh, no, let's talk about the songs first, wait. So when I first asked Michelle what songs Uncle John would like to do, she immediately came up with 10 songs. She said, these 10 songs. I said, wow, so fast, how come you know? She said, I know because he always plays these.
Easier, right? So I had to like rack my brains, like what song, then must rehearse, must practice extra things. Okay. So these are songs that I'm sure he likes it, that's why... He plays it so much.
I like them very much too.
Yeah.
And it really brightened my mood just now when we were rehearsing. Yeah. So I was telling them that it felt like I was transported to somewhere in Europe. Although I've never really been to Europe. I've seen pictures. So it felt like I was in those pictures. Yeah. So we hope you have the same kind of mood when you're enjoying the songs with us. Our next song is The Shadow of Your Smile. I didn't do research for this song. So I don't know where it came from. Where did it come from? Do you know?
Came from the real book.
Okay, anyway, I really like this song and we hope you like this too. Shadow of your smile when you are gone will color all my dreams and light the dawn. Look into my eyes, my love, and see lovely A teardrop kissed your lips, and so the shadow of your smile. Now, if we had a green screen here, we would put like a picture of I don't know, mountains in Europe, yeah. Italy, Switzerland.
Yeah, oh, and clear green screen.
Yeah, huh? Right. So we hope that song transported you
back
or to wherever you know that brings you fond memories. And Christine says the shadow of your smile is her dad's favorite song. I'm glad you like it.
Thanks, Uncle Tom. He loved the song.
Okay, let me just
and thanks, Chris. Hi, Chris. Thank you.
Is Chris on YouTube?
Yes, he's on YouTube.
Hello, Chris. Sorry, I'm trying to multitask.
With my aunt from Perth. She says, "Hello, hi, Kuche, from Perth."
Hello, Michelle's Kuche.
Yeah, they're stuck in Perth. We're stuck here.
Yeah, but Perth okay. Open up already,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, they're like normal.
Yeah, that's great. That's great. That's great. Okay, come. What is our next song?
Oh, your father-in-law says, the shadow of your smile is the love theme from The Sandpiper.
Sandpiper. Have you watched the movie? Do you know, Uncle John? No? Okay, it's time to watch The Sandpiper. Okay. Marcus Tang says, enjoying song with fish and chips. Thank you for having dinner while, enjoying the music with us. And hello, who is Ying Lo? Ying Yi Lo? Oh, that's your auntie, No, right?
No.
Encore. Okay, we'll do some other songs later, okay? Okay, next song we have is Night and Day. This is something from
Did you do research?
Yeah,
on this?
I did research. Cole Porter. Again, introduced by Fred Astaire in 1932. Very long ago. 1932 is how many years ago? 80 years ago? No, more than that. Sorry, my math is very bad. 90. Oh my gosh, 90 years ago. Okay, let's do this 90-year-old song. Night and Day.
Why do we play so old songs?
But standards are like that, huh? That's why.
Yeah,
but
true,
the great thing
true.
Is they're still current. I mean, we're
it's
still enjoying
true.
Them till
right.
this day. Yeah.
That's right. Good with fish and chips.
Near to me. it's no matter, darling, where you are, I think of you. Night and day, day and night, why is it so that this longing for you follows wherever I go? In the roaring traffic's boom, in the silence of my lonely room, I think of you. Day and night, night and day, under the height of me, there's an oh such a hungry yearning burning inside of me, and its torment won't be through till you let me spend my life making love to you. Day and night, night and day. That was a 90-year-old song called Night and Day. Okay, the next song that we have for you. If you feel like cha-cha-ing at home, this song should do it for you. Just get up and do it. No one's watching anyway, except maybe your kids and your pets, but that's okay. The next song is called Tea for Two.
Just me for you and you for me alone. Nobody near us to see us or hear us. No friends or relations on weekend vacations. We won't have it known, dear, that we own a telephone, dear. Day will break and I'll awaken, start to bake a sugar cake for you to take, for all the boys to see. We will raise a family, a girl for you and a boy for me. Oh, can't you see how happy we would be? picture me upon your knee, just 2 for 2 and 2 for tea, just me for you and you for me alone. Nobody near us to see us or hear us, no friends or relations on weekend vacations. We won't have it, no dear, that we own a telephone. Dear, day will break and I'll awaken, start to bake a sugar cake for you to take, for all the boys to see. See how happy we would be. Oh, can't you see how happy we would be? Yes, can you see how happy we would be?
Yay, thank you. Did you cha-cha with us at home? That was tea for two. Now, the thing about standards, like we were talking about, is that you don't really know who the original singer of the piece is. They have become so common, so well-loved, that every piece is sung by a great singer with an awesome version of it. Now, the next piece that we have, you want to say hello first to anybody? Okay. Before we introduce our next piece? Because you seem to be looking at comments.
My cousins are here on YouTube.
Hello, cousins!
Serene and Samuel. Samuel is asking, is that Tony Leung? I don't know why, Sam. Why Tony Leung? Does Doku look like Tony Leung?
Shang-Chi! So cute. Is that... Sorry, that's your cousin, you said?
Yeah, the cousin in Perth.
How old is your cousin?
He's 12 years younger than me. So... Wait. Yeah, 12 years younger
than me. So he's not a child, lah.
No, sorry.
I thought you mistook the uncle for superhero. I haven't watched it yet. Have you watched Shang-Chi?
No, haven't watched.
No, okay, yes. Lots of good reviews. So yes, we're doing publicity for Shang-Chi, which doesn't need publicity.
Does this look like Tony Leung?
Okay, like y'all can have a discussion about that later. Tony Leung, Leung Chu Wai.
My mother doesn't really watch.
No?
Watch movies.
Really?
Doesn't know. Yeah.
Okay, you show him one of the movies he will know.
You ask him about guitars, maybe he'll tell you more.
Okay, maybe Tony Leung plays guitar.
Okay, yes, maybe.
Okay. Okay, so the next song we have is something that all of you should recognize. This was actually a pop song of his era, the song I researched. 1977. Okay.
You're getting younger.
Yeah, like not how this is still
closer
very old, you know.
Age.
I didn't realize that, yeah, it's almost 50 years old. Okay, so this song that was a pop song then is almost 50 years old. Wow. Okay, so once we play the intro line, you should recognize it. But we have our own little version of it, so maybe you won't recognize it so quickly. But if you know the song, you know, you can make it in the comments. You can, yeah, make your comments known. There's no prize. Don't go changing to try and please me. You never let me down before. Don't imagine you're too familiar, and I don't see you. We never could have come this far. I took the good times, I'll take the bad times, I'll take you just the way you are. Don't go trying some new fashion. Don't change the color of your hair. You'll always have my
compassion. Although I might not seem to care, I don't want clever conversation. I never want to work that hard. I just want someone that I can talk to. I want you just the way you are. I need to know that you will always be the same old someone that I knew. What will it take till you that I knew. What will it take till you believe in me the way that I believe in you? I said I love you, and that's forever, and this I promise from the heart. I couldn't love you any better. I love you just the way you are.
That was Just the Way You Are. If you recognize that song by Billy Joel, the song is already almost 50 years old, the pop song of its era from 1977. Now, the next song we have for you is an instrumental played by our very talented father and daughter duo. This next song is called Pebble Beach. Any significance why you chose this song?
I just like this song.
You just like the song? Okay, anyway, just FYI, I think this is the first time that John and Michelle are playing on live stream together.
Yes.
And this is Uncle John's first time on live stream, yeah. Is it? Yes, yes. Is it fun talking to the camera? Okay, so I'll leave Michelle and Uncle John with Pebble Beach.
Thank you.
thank you. And that was a father-daughter version of Pebble Beach. What's the meaning of the song? Are they like taking a walk by the beach and picking pebbles?
I don't know. I think Pebble Beach is a
place.
A golf course, maybe.
Golf course?
Yeah, a golf course. Maybe. I think so.
Okay, that's interesting. That someone will write about golf course.
Yeah, but it always gives a very holiday feel.
It does.
This song.
Oh. Yeah.
So now especially, we all cannot travel.
Especially when we can't go on holidays.
So this
you can still take the cruise to nowhere.
Yeah,
maybe there was a cool song.
The song wouldn't be the same like you're on the water to nowhere.
Okay. What's our next song? Let me see. Oh, the next song is a song called Besame Mucho. Let me just share a little short story about my experience with this song. So when I first started gigging about 15 years ago, this musician friend of mine told me that... I'm not supposed to tell you the title yet. Okay, this song is supposed to be sung in verse, chorus, verse. Means that you don't repeat the first verse. So it's verse, chorus, verse. So every time I sang the song, it will be verse, chorus, verse. And I always check with the musicians. I will always ask them, can we sing this song in verse, chorus, verse? Because someone told me that it's supposed to be this version. And that all the other musicians are playing it wrong. So every time I told them this story about what the first musician told me, they'll be very puzzled. But they will still, they will still be very compromising. They say, it's okay, you're the singer, you just sing whatever you're comfortable with, we'll follow you. So later on, I became very confused myself. So I went around asking all my musician friends, so what is the correct version? Is it supposed to be verse, chorus, verse, or verse, verse, chorus, verse? And they all said, we have never heard of verse, chorus, verse, verse, chorus, verse version of this. But well, as long as you're happy doing it. So tonight, we will play the correct version of this song. It's actually called Besame Mucho. And I hope this is the correct version. I don't know why that musician told me such a fallacy, but well. This is Besame Mucho, which is a Spanish tune, written in 1940.
Besame mucho, como si fueras la noche la última vez. Besame, besame mucho, que tengo miedo de verte perderte después. Bésame, bésame mucho, como si fueras la noche la última vez. Bésame, bésame mucho, que tengo miedo de verte perderte después. Sentirte, me seca, mírame, ven junto a mí. Piensa que tal vez mañana yo ya estaré lejos, muy lejos de aquí. Bésame, bésame mucho, como si fueras la noche la última vez. Thank you. sentirte me seca, me rame, en junto, ven junto a mí. Piensa que el tal vez mañana yo ya es muy lejos de aquí. Bésame, bésame mucho, como si fueras la noche la última vez. Bésame, bésame mucho, que tengo miedo de verte, perderte después. Que tengo miedo de verte, perderte después. Tengo miedo perderte, perderte
cha-cha-cha. Yes, and Besame Mucho. You know, I always thought that this song meant too much sesame. But no, but actually meant kiss me much. Kiss me much.
Too much sesame.
Too much sesame. Okay, what is our next song? Hello, everyone who's just joined us. Okay, the next song is a very sad tune with lyrics to match. Now, it's a song about love lost through the imagery of dead autumn leaves. Where's that, right?
Dead autumn leaves.
So, here's something from 1945. It's called Autumn Leaves, which is originally a French tune, but I'll be singing it in English today. The fallen leaves drift by my window. The autumn leaves of red and gold. And I see your lips, the summer kisses. When the autumn
sunburned hands I used to hold since you went away.
We hope you like our version of a sad song called Autumn Leaves. Tonight is the night of jazz standards, and the next piece that we have for you is something popularized by Engelbert Humperdinck. In 1968, now legend has it that he was such a stud that when he performed, his female fans would throw stuff at him. I think those who know the music of that era, you will know what stuff he gets thrown at. Don't even throw anything at me, you know. But you can enjoy the music, and we hope that our music transports you to, I don't know, Europe or wherever you want a holiday. Yes.
Fun fact, my dad actually met Engelbert, but I don't know how to pronounce his name.
Engelbert Humperdinck.
Mr. Humperdinck. he met him at Capella. Yeah, he was staying there. Yeah.
Really? When was this?
Before COVID.
Oh, yeah, but not too long ago, right? In the last 10 years? Less than 10 years, yeah, because Capella hasn't been around for too long. Wow, and did you say hello?
Yeah, yeah. Is he friendly? We got a picture together.
Did you throw anything at him? Oh, you got pictures together? That's nice. Okay, so he's as suave as what you see in the videos. Oh, that's awesome. With the kalipok hair? No. Okay, so not so poofy lah. Okay, so here is a song popularized by the one and only Mr. Humperdinck. You should know the song lah, huh? Everyone should know the song. Tell me, when will you be mine? Tell me quando. We can share a love divine. Please don't make me wait again. When will you say yes to me? Tell me quando. You mean happiness to me. Oh my darling, tell me when. Every moment's a day. Every day. Show you the way to a joy beyond compare. I can wait a moment more. Tell me quando. Say it's me that you adore. Oh my darling, tell me when. Show you the way
joy beyond compare. I can wait a moment more. Tell me quando, quando, quando. Say it's me that you adore. Oh, my darling, tell me when.
Should we squeeze in the other song as well? Let's do it, lah, huh?
Okay.
Okay.
We've got not much time.
Never mind. Let's just squeeze it in. Okay, so we hope you have enjoyed our night of jazz standards. Let's squeeze in two more songs, okay? If you don't mind hanging around for a bit more. We're enjoying ourselves. Really, really, I am. I love this. Because I haven't performed with the guitar in a long time. Piano, yes. But guitar, no. So the feel is very different. Okay, so anyway, here is The Days of Wine and Roses. You know, this song is a standard, right? It's, yeah. But I've never sung this until today. So this is my debut of this song.
Introduced me to
Okay, we have time for one more song. The last song we have is... Okay, so tonight is a night of standards, right? Jazz standards, our final song, is a Jesus standard that every church-going child would have sung in Sunday school. Here's our jazzy version of this classic. We hope you recognize this song, and please sing along, don't be shy. It's called What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Have. Thank you so much to all for joining us on this Friday evening. No, it's not evening anymore, it's night. It's late at night, but thank you so much for staying with us all the way for our second episode. We have more episodes coming up, so we hope for your continued support. Now, tonight we featured Michelle's father, Uncle John Yap. Thank you so much for joining us. It is truly my pleasure to have performed with you. Thank you. And next episode, we will bring my son Joshua back with his grandfather, who's our special guest, and also Tony Z, who was a very prolific drummer in Singapore. And Tony and my father-in-law actually knew each other from the days of the trailers, if you know. So please join us then. That will be on the
8th
of October.
October.
August is over. So, thank you so much for joining us once again, and we hope you have a wonderful evening, wonderful weekend, and for parents, wonderful week of HBL. You know, here we go with our 5 and 2 again, but you know, the only 5 and 2 you should remember is 5 loaves and 2 fishes.
And bye-bye. Thank you, Chris.
Thank you, Chris, from Eden. Yes, thank you for making this possible.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good night.